Praise the Lord, everybody. It's Word Wednesday time. Let's enter into his gates with thanksgiving. Enter his courts with praise. We're grateful and we bless his name. Praise his holy name. God bless you. Good evening. It's Word Wednesday time. Come on in the house. Let's give God some glory, honor, and praise. Come on, let's sing together. Let it rise.
Let it rise.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, let the glory of the Lord rise. Let the glory of the Lord rise up. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let it rise. Come on in the house. Let the glory of the Lord rise. Come on, sing with me. Let it rise. Good Wednesday evening. We're letting the glory of the Lord rise this evening. Come on, let's bless his name. We bless your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. You're worthy. We bless your name. Sing a song. Hallelujah. Let it rise. Let the joy. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Let the glory of the Lord rise. Come on, let it rise. Sing a song, yes. Let the joy of our King. Somebody need to let the glory of the Lord rise. Oh.
Let it rise.
Come on, sing it with me. Oh, oh, oh. With a loud voice, let it rise. Come on, put those hands together. Put those glad hands together. Hallelujah, Jesus. We bless your name. Arise. Let the glory of the Lord arise among us. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let it rise. Come on, put those hands together. Yes. Arise. Let the songs of the Lord
rise.
Hallelujah. Let the joy of the Lord be your strength today. Bless your wonderful name. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Come on, put those glad hands together. Oh, come on, put them together. Let's bless that wonderful name. Yes, Lord. Come on, put those hands together. We bless your name. We bless your name. We bless your name. Your holy name. Come on, we bless your name. Your holy name. We bless your name. Your holy name. Come on, sing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Hallelujah. Ah, yes, praise his wonderful name on this evening. Oh, I ain't got a church in the house this evening. Praise the Lord for you. God bless you, Church One Charlotte. Far and near, your brother, Pastor Charles Carter, the Church One family, Church One Charlotte family, and Church One Global as a whole. God bless you. Coming to you from our stay-at-home studios, we just want to let the glory of the Lord rise. Amen. Oh, my goodness. Is that your testimony on this evening? Praise God for you, Sister Nikki Miller. Amen. Sister Gabby, I know, is right there with her. Amen. Missionary Marion Williams, Brother Arthur Tyler, Stacy Felder. Trustee Rodney Thompson, praise God for you all. Amen. I know Grayson's in the house there somewhere also. Praise God for you. Amen. We thank God for all of those that are joining us. It's Word Jeopardy time. One more time. Amen. Having such a wonderful time with this. We had to do round three. So we thank God for you. Grab your Bibles. Grab your various electronic devices. Excuse me. And let's get ready for round three of Word Jeopardy. Amen. We just thank God for the opportunity to do this once again. It's been evident that it's been a blessing. And I know if it's been blessing me, I know it's been a blessing to you also. Want to thank God for you. We're in prayer for those that are experiencing inclement weather. The blessings of the Lord keep you where you are. Amen. That all might be well. Praying for our brothers and sisters on the West Coast experiencing wildfires and things of those nature. We want you to know that the prayers of the righteous avails much. And your brothers and sisters at Church One Charlotte and Church One Global are keeping you lift it up in prayer. Amen. Those that are experiencing illness, whether it be physical or otherwise, we're continuously in prayer for you. Yes, we are, not just in word, but indeed. Join us every Monday, 7 p.m., our Church One Word line. Join us for prayer, 7 p.m. We pray for about 15 minutes and the Lord blesses and it gets the week going. Amen. So we just thank God for that. Wednesdays, we're right here at 7 o'clock, 5:30, 6:30 or so. We're still doing our youth Zoom rooms. Keep your ears open for those and for the Zoom links on our Church One page. For those that are unable to join us live, we encourage you to join us. You can go to Facebook.com/Church One Charlotte and see all previous recordings of our entire library. Amen. So make sure you check that out. For those that are not on Facebook, you can join us also. Like and subscribe on YouTube /Church One Charlotte. You can find us in all of our various recordings within 30 minutes of the end of every service we do. They're there. YouTube can be a lot easier to share with many for those that you might want to share with. So make sure you check that out also if you have need. And also, and as always, 12:30 every Sunday, we're right here for Sunday service. Amen. And God is meeting us in a powerful way and we thank him for it. All right. Well, it's about that time. We're continuing. Who's joining us so far? Do we have any more joining us? I want to say God bless you to all those that are joining us. As you join, if this is your first time, give us a hello and a God bless you that we might give you a shout out right where you are. Amen. Amen. We're going to get started. It's Word Jeopardy time. Once again, remembering and reminding everyone of how we play. It's very similar to the television game show. You have to answer every question or every answer has to be made in the form of a question. So if we say the day of the week that comes after Sunday, you would say, what is Monday? Amen. Alisa Brown, God bless you. Good to see you. Amen. So we're getting ready to get started. We're getting started. We're picking right up from where we left off last week. And we're giving passages of scripture that you might make note and continue to study these areas. Amen. Bible says, your word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against you, that I might not miss out on the plan that you have for my life, God. Amen. So we're studying to show ourselves approved, workmen not ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. That's Bible. Amen. So let's get right into it. Genesis 37th chapter. Genesis 37th chapter, third verse is going to give you the answer that you have to answer in the form of a question. It's going to give you the answer to this very question. What piece of clothing made Joseph's brothers jealous? What piece of clothing made Joseph's brothers jealous? We're going to give you 30 seconds to answer. And you have, as of right now, we're going to get ready for the countdown. And as of right now, you have 30 seconds. Go for it. Amen. 30 seconds, go right ahead. What article of clothing made Joseph's brothers jealous? You say, well, there's more than one Joseph in the Bible. According to Genesis 37 and 3. We've got people getting ready to answer here in the Church One Stay at Home Studios. All right. There's our time. The question one more time. What piece of clothing made Joseph's brothers jealous? According to Genesis 37 and 3. We're giving, we've got some answers coming in here. We're giving everyone a chance to join. Make quick reference and try to jot it down as quickly as possible. All right. What article of clothing made Joseph's brothers jealous? Amen. We've got two answers. All right. We've got one here in the house. Go ahead, Kayla. What answer do you have? All right. All right. That's one answer. All right. And the answer we have online is Lydia says, what is the coat of many colors? Both of y'all are very correct. If y'all couldn't hear, Kayla said a special jacket. Yes, indeed. All right. So you both are correct. Come on, give yourselves a hand. Amen. Praise God. You know what? I got to get me a clap track going here at some point so we can give some shout outs and some claps going on when the right answers come together. So amen. Praise God for you. That is correct. I'm going to read it real quick. Genesis 37 and 3. Genesis 37 and 3. I'm going to read it in your hearing. I want you to read along with me. Genesis 37, verse 3. And it reads, if it'll ever load up here for me, come on here. Genesis 37 and 3. And it reads, come on, sometime today. There we go. Praise God. Genesis 37 and 3 says, now Israel loved Joseph more than any of his other sons because he had been born to him in his old age. And he made an ornate robe for him. That's the NIV version. The New Living Translation says, he made Joseph a special gift, a beautiful robe. King James Version says that he made him a coat of many colors. That might be the one many are familiar with. Amen. With that translation. So praise God for it. That's wonderful. A coat of many colors. Praise God. All right, we're moving on to the next one. Come on, everybody, come right along. Next question. Now, I think we got to remind everyone that we're answering in the form of a question, right? So remember, when you give your answer, you're answering in the form of a question. Next question. According to Ruth, the book of Ruth, chapter 1, verses 22, how was Ruth related to Naomi? How was Ruth related to Naomi? You have 30 seconds. Let's go. Ready, go. You got 30 seconds. How was Ruth related to Naomi? In the form of a question. How was Ruth related to Naomi? According to Ruth, first chapter, 22nd verse. All right. Time's up. Good job. Now, let's get those answers in. Anyone that has an answer, come on and chime in with those answers. How was Ruth related to Naomi according to Ruth chapter 1, verse 22? Ruth chapter 1, verse 22. We've got an answer here in the studio. We've got an answer also online. And I'm going to read. Go ahead, Kayla. What's the answer? What answer do you have? All right. Now, what answer do we have? Is that Lydia online there? All right. That's Mary. That's Missionary Mary Williams. All right. She's put, what is her sister? All right. Let's go to the word so we can verify the answer. Does Sister Nikki have one in there also? All right. Sister Nikki says daughter-in-law. So we've heard, I think somebody said son, sister, and daughter-in-law. All right. Here we go. Ruth chapter 1, verse 22. And it reads, so Naomi returned, and Ruth, the Moabites, her daughter-in-law, with her. All right. Now, let's read that one more time. So Naomi returned, and Ruth, the Moabites, her daughter-in-law, with Ruth, her daughter-in-law. NIV says it this way. So Naomi returned from Moab, accompanied by Ruth, the Moabite, her daughter-in-law. Now, the question was, once again, how was Ruth related to Naomi? So the answer is, drum roll, Ruth was Naomi's daughter-in-law. Praise God. Good job. Good job. Good job. Good thinking. All right. Awesome. Moving right along. Come on. We're rocking and rolling here. We're moving right along. Out of the following, this is a good one. Out of the following, which did God not tell the Israelites to do in order to keep his commandments on their hearts? According to Deuteronomy 6, verses 6 through 9. Deuteronomy 6, verses 6 through 9. Out of the following, which did God not tell the Israelites to do in order to keep his commandments on their hearts? Here are the answers. Tell which one he did not tell them. Teach the commandments to their children. Defend the commandments in response to gods of the peoples around them. Talk of them when they sit in their homes, when they walk around, when they lie down, and when they rise. Or write them on the doorposts of their houses. Which one, I'll read again, did God not tell the Israelites to do in order to keep his commandments in their hearts? According to Deuteronomy 6, 6 through 9. Here are your options. Which ones that he did not tell them to do? Teach the commandments to the children. Defend the commandments in response to the gods of the peoples around them. Talk of them when they sit in their homes, when they walk around, and when they lie down, and when they rise. Or write them on the doorposts of their houses. According to Deuteronomy 6, 6 through 9, which one did he not tell the children of Israel to take part in? You've got 60 seconds. We're getting ready, and I'm getting the music ready. Here we go. You've got 60 seconds, and go. Deuteronomy 6, 6 through 9. Which one did God not tell the children of Israel, to do in order to keep his commandments on their heart? According to Deuteronomy 6, verses 6 through 9. Did he tell them to tell their children about it? That's number one. Did he tell them to defend it? Your time is up. I'm going to read once again. Did he tell them to teach the commandments to the children? One. Did he not tell them to defend the commandments? Did he not tell them to talk about the commandments? Or did he not tell them to write the commandments? Which one of those four did he not tell? To teach, to defend, to talk, or to write? Which one? I got some hands up here at the stay-at-home studio. We got a couple answers. We got Gabby answering. We got one. All right. Sister Gabby's saying, what is to not talk of them in their house? That's Lydia. I'm sorry. And Gabby Thompson, what did Gabby say? Did Gabby have something? All right. Do not write on the doorpost. Kayla, what did you have there? Okay. Number three was to talk of them when they sit in their homes, walk around and lie down. Well, let's go to Deuteronomy 6:6-9 and get the answer. Deuteronomy, that's Old Testament. Deuteronomy 6:6-9. And it reads, I'm reading verses 6-9, and it reads, in the King James, I'll read first, NIV, I'll read next. And these words which I command thee this day shall be in thine heart, and thou shalt teach them diligently unto your children. All right. So we know that was one that he told them actually to do. And shalt talk of them when thou sittest in thine house, and when thou walkest by the way, and when thou liest down, and when thou risest up. So we know that's one of them, to talk about it. And thou shalt bind them for a sign upon thy hand, and shall be as frontlets between thy eyes, and thou shalt write them upon the posts of thy house and on their gates. I'm gonna read that in the NIV so it can make some sense in modern day English. Come on, somebody. All right, but I think y'all see where it's going. Verse 6, these commandments that I give you today are to be on your hearts. Impress them on your children. That means to teach. Talk about them when you sit at home, when you walk around along the road, and when you lie down, and when you get up. Tie them as symbols on your hands and bind them on your foreheads. Verse 5, write them on the door frames of your houses and on your gates. All right, so we know that he told us to teach our children, to talk about it, and to put it on our doorposts. So those are the three that we know that were instructed in Deuteronomy 6:6-9. So the answer is to defend. What is to defend the commandments in response to the gods of other peoples around them? That was the one that God did not give the children of Israel and Moses to do when he gave the Ten Commandments. So, all right, it was number three is the answer. All right, good job, everyone. Good studying. Y'all are digging in. Come on, let's keep going. First, okay, now next one. According to Genesis 8, we hanging out in the Old Testament today. Genesis number 8, chapter 8. Verses 6-9. Genesis 8, 6-9. God bless you. Linnell Rollins, God bless you. Good to see you. Welcome to Word Jeopardy on a Wednesday night. According to Genesis 8th chapter, verses 6-9. Noah sent two birds from the ark. What were they? Noah sent two birds from the ark. What were they? You're going to have 60 seconds. I'm going to cue it up here for us. You have 60 seconds. We're going to give you, and we're starting that in just one moment. So you're getting a few extra moments to get going. You have 60 seconds. Go. Noah sent two birds out from the ark. What were they? In the form of a question, what were they? All right, time is up.
Noah sent two birds, according to Genesis 8, 6 through 9. He sent two birds from the ark. What were they? All right, we've got some answers. All right, we got some answers in-house, and we got some answers also online. All right, let's see. We've got Kayla, we got Layla, and we got Lydia. Layla says, what is doves? Lydia, excuse me, says also, what is doves? Kayla, what's your answer? What are doves? All right. So let's see what we got. Genesis. We're going to Genesis 8, 6 through 9. And it reads, I'm going to read in the NIV so we can cut to the chase. Verse 6 says, after 40 days, Noah opened a window he had made in the ark. Verse 7, and set out a raven and kept it flying back and forth until the water had dried up from the earth. Verse 8, then he sent out a dove to see if the water had receded from the surface of the ground. Verse 9, but the dove could find nowhere to perch because there was water over all the surface of the earth. So it returned to Noah in the ark. He reached out his hand and took the dove and brought him back to himself in the ark. So according to Genesis 8, 6 through 9, and that was somewhat of a trick question. Well, it wasn't a trick question because it basically did give you a hint that it was two different birds, not just one. Not only was it a dove, but it was also a raven. All right. Good job, y'all. Good job. All right. We're going to keep on rolling. We're getting close to wrapping up time. We're going to do one or two more here real quick. So come on and chime on in as we wrap up. All right. According to, let's see. Oh, yeah. You know what? I'm going to do this one because this is a book of the Bible that it's going to take some work to find. All right. Somebody go ahead and grab Philemon 2 and 3. I'm sorry, Philemon 2. I'm trying to see. I'm trying to make sure I'm giving it to you right here. 2nd and 3rd John and Jude. Okay, so there's a couple different places to find it. Yep, okay. Oh, okay, I'm sorry. I just gave you the answer. Here's a good one. Name one of the five books of the Bible that contain only one chapter, and I gave it to you. I thought that was the scripture and verse, but that's a good one. And this is a good one, so mark this and make note of this. The answer is Obadiah. And for bonus points, some of the other ones are Philemon, 2nd and 3rd John, and Jude. So there are our answers right there. Those are five books that have only one chapter. All right. So you can scroll through the scriptures and find those for your sake of knowing and getting understanding. Moving on, let's grab another one here. Okay. Luke 19 and 8. Grab Luke 19 and 8. The question is, how much of his wealth did Zacchaeus give to the poor? According to Luke 19 and 8, how much of his riches did Zacchaeus give to the poor? How much of his riches did Zacchaeus give to the poor? You've got 60 seconds beginning now. How much of his riches did Zacchaeus give to the poor? Time's up. All right. Now, in the form of a question, according to Luke 19 and 8, how much of his wealth did Zacchaeus give to the poor? If you got answers, come on and give them to me here online. If we've got any answers here in the house, come on, let's chime in with them. Luke 19 and 8. According to Luke 19 and 8, how much of his wealth did Zacchaeus give to the poor? All right, we've got one answer from Lydia and Gabby. Lydia and Gabby are both saying half. All right, Kayla, what do you got? What do you have there? You said, what is all his wealth? Okay, all right, let's go grab it. Luke, the book of Luke, 19 and 8, I believe it was, right? The answer is found in the word. All right. According to Luke 19, verse 8, and it reads, but Zacchaeus stood up and said to the Lord, look, Lord, here and now I give half of my possessions to the poor. And if I have cheated anybody out of anything, I will pay back four times the amount. Brother Rodney Thompson says, what is half? Amen. Come on, everybody. Yes, indeed. Come on, say half. Amen. Yes, indeed. Come on, half. Somebody know where I'm going with that. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Come on. Zacchaeus gave half of all his wealth to the poor. Amen. All right. We wrapping up. Here's the last one. Let's do one good one to wrap it up. Okay. Let's see. I'm going to skip around here a little bit. All right. Here's a good one. Acts, the 9th chapter, verses 3 and 4. Acts, the 9th chapter, verses 3 and 4. And the question is, to what city was Saul traveling when he saw a great light and Jesus asked, why do you persecute me? Acts 9, verses 3 and 4. We're going to give you a few minutes, a few moments here to look that up and to get that. Where was Saul traveling to? And here's the bonus question. What did Saul's name get changed to? And if you know the passage of scripture, oh, you really something serious. Amen. Praise God. So I'm going to give you some time here to get the answer. And we're going to give you some time to chime in. God bless you, Pop Bennett. Good to see you. Mom and Pop Bennett, God bless you. Answering in the form of a question. What city was Saul traveling to when he saw a great light and Jesus asked, why do you persecute me? All right, time's up. According to Acts, the book of Acts, according to the book of Acts, where was Saul traveling to when he saw a great light and Jesus asked, why do you persecute me? All right, we got an answer in the house. I think we got a couple. I'm trying to give you a few more moments. I know there's a few chiming in. And this is according to the book of Acts, chapter 9, verses 3 and 4. Acts 9, verses 3 and 4. Where was Saul traveling to? And the bonus question is, what did Saul's name get changed to? Mom Bennett, God bless you. Good to see you. All right. Is that Mom or Pop Bennett chiming in with the answer? Okay, gotcha. All right. All right. Now, what you got there? Go ahead and shorthand it for me here. Praise God. Everybody joining in. All right. All right. Okay. Okay, let's see. We got the prophet Loel James saying, what is Tarsus? All right. All right. Now Layla says, what is Damascus? Gabby says, what is Paul? To the answer to the second question. And Lydia also says Damascus. All right. Do we have any in the house? All right. Now I'm going to go grab it. Acts, the 9th chapter. God bless you, Pastor Loel James. Good to see you also, sir. We're coming from Acts, the 9th chapter, verses 3 and 4. The question is, where was Paul traveling to when he saw a great light? Not where he was traveling from, but where he was traveling to when he saw a great light. And Jesus asked Saul, why do you persecute me? Verses 3 and 4, and it reads right here. It says, As he neared Damascus on his journey, suddenly a light from heaven flashed around him. He fell to the ground and heard a voice say to him, "Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me?" And as with the bonus question that many answered, what was the name that Saul's name was changed to? And many of our awesome Bible theologians answered, the answer there was Paul. Amen. Praise God for you all. Well, that's all our time for this evening. We want to thank you for joining us in our Church One Home Studios. And wherever you are, far and near, thank you for joining us on Word Jeopardy. God bless you. We'll see you next time. God bless.